How did you get hooked up with this project, Ana DuVernay and Colin Kaepernick, for clearly a series that we're going to have quite a spotlight on when it comes out?
You know, Ava reached out to me. I had read about, you know, it in the trades, you know, that they were doing a limited series on Colin's life. And then Ava reached out and said, hey, Robert, would you be interested in directing a few episodes? And I go, I am so curious about this man and his journey. I would love to be a part of it. And then I started to do a lot of research on him, and his story is quite a journey. And so that's how I got involved, and I'm so proud of this limited series.
So you met with Colin? You chatted with him prior to all this?
Yes, we met over Zoom because the world was still shut down.
Right.
And so we had a beautiful conversation over Zoom and just, you know, talking about his life and talking about the whys. And when I read the script, he says, all of this is true. And I was like, oh, my God. And so it's kind of like this innocent kid that, you know, just loves sports. He's a great athlete in baseball, football, and basketball. And he just loves sports. And he's trying to figure out life. And then all of a sudden, he's thrown a few curves as a kid.
Well, I met Colin Kaepernick in the old studios of NFL Network when he was coming out of Nevada, hoping to be drafted in the NFL as high as his dream would take him, and then I interviewed him as he found himself a quarterback in the Super Bowl out of nowhere, essentially, and so I interviewed him in his sort of like gee willikers, wide-eyed part of his life. How did you find him when you started to meet him, Robert Townsend?
Well, you know, let me say this. He is the nicest man. He's really grounded. He's really focused, and he's really kind. And what I've, you know, learned from him, you know, in the times that we've talked, is that he was just this innocent kid that just goes, what's going on outside of the NFL is not fair, and how do I do something about it? And somebody suggested taking a knee, and he did. So it was like this, you know, so when I talked to the man, it was like, he says, Rob, you know, crazy stuff was going on, and I have a good life, and I'm concerned about what's happening in the world. So he found his voice because he wanted to do something.
Robert Townsend here on The Rich Eisen Show. Episodes 3 and 4 of the limited series, you want to let people know which part of his life did you direct in those episodes, Robert?
There's two episodes. One episode is called Road Trip, and basically it is when he kind of is discovers racism. He's like, you know, one of two black players on the team, and he starts to have these moments where he goes, maybe it's me, maybe it's not, and then he goes, wait a minute, they're treating me differently because of the color of my skin. And it gets into a lot of real stuff that I can identify with as a man of color. And then the other episode is called The Decision. What people don't know is that Colin had all the letters to play college baseball. He didn't get one letter until the ninth hour to play. Only one school reached out about football. Other than that, he had 25 to 30 letters from all the top universities to play baseball. So he has to make this decision, and the world is against him. I mean, wait till you see the episode. The world is against him.
Right.
And this little baby, this little kid goes, no, I believe I could be a quarterback, and it just breaks your heart, and he wins.
Adapted by white parents, played by Nick Offerman and Mary Louise Parker, correct? In this series?
Yes, two amazing actors. I mean, they capture the parents, because the parents, you know, they wanted to adopt, you know, they want to do the right thing and, you know, raise, you know, help the planet because there's so many kids that weren't adopted, and they do the right thing, and then they find that they have this phenom that can play all sports, and they were like, wow. And his dad, you know, have encouraged him, and they're like the biggest sports fans as well. But it's their journey because they didn't know how to raise a black kid.
It is Robert Townsend, the director of a couple of episodes of Netflix's Colin in Black and White, co-created by Colin Kaepernick and Ava DuVernay, who's as big a name as you can possibly get here in this town, right here on The Rich Eisen Show. So did you talk to Colin about whether he wants to continue playing football? Did that ever conversation come up with you at all, Robert, to basically potentially inform you in whatever way you needed to be as a director for something in the past? Did you talk about the present and future with him at any point in time?
We didn't really get into it. I just know that he stays ready. He stays ready. I mean, he loves the game of football. I mean, that's his passion, his heart. And like I said, no one knows what's going to happen in the future, mm-hmm. but I just know that he stays ready. So we will see if anything happens, but, you know, he has a certain kind of focus that is like, you know, one of those like high achievers where he loves what he does. He's one of the top quarterbacks. And so if that happens, I would be excited, but I think when people see this limited series, you understand how he became who he became.
And it comes out on October 29th, available on Netflix, Colin in Black and White. So did Colin Kaepernick watch Hollywood Shuffle in advance of your conversation at any point in time, Robert Townsend?
I don't know about that, but he's a fan. I mean, he loves, you know, like all the movies that I've done. And, mm-hmm. you know, we talked a little bit about that. But he's just, you know, he's a big kid. You know, what people don't understand is, like, I think the beautiful thing about this limited series, you know, it will give you the human side of the man. I think a lot of times people see him as this, you know, larger-than-life figure, which he is. But he, at the core, he was just a little innocent kid that, you know, saw some injustice and said, I got to do something about it. And it started when he was a kid. So you know, but he is a fan. He is a fan.
Well, as am I. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.